In this video, we're going to finish out the similar triangles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the geometry section, picking up where we left off with number 13 on the third page. Now, our instructions are to find the missing length, and the triangles in each pair are similar. Since the triangles are similar, that means the angles are congruent and the sides are proportional. So in number 13, we can say this side, LJ of 28 over the missing length KJ, that is proportional to RP, the larger side, 42, over the side QP of 33. So now we'll cross multiply and solve for KJ. 28 times 33 is equal to segment KJ times 42. 28 times 33 is 924, and that's equal to KJ times 42. So if we divide both sides by 42, we'll get that 924 divided by 42 is 22, and that is equal to the length of KJ. So 22 is our missing length in number 13. And number 14, KL over LM, 130 over 117, is going to be proportional to VU, which is 60, since that corresponds with KL, over UT, since segment UT corresponds with LM of 117. Now, we'll cross multiply and see what that segment UT is equal to. 117 times 60 is equal to 130 times UT. 117 times 60 is 7,020, and that's equal to 130 times UT. When I divide by 130, I'll get that 54 is equal to UT. So 54 is our missing length in number 14. In number 15, I'm looking for SB. And if the two triangles are similar, that means that the length SU over the length UT is proportional to the length BU over the length CU. So we need to solve for BU and then subtract that from 12 to get SB, since SB plus BU equals SU. So SU we know is 12, so 12 over UT, which we need to calculate. If UC is 6 and CT is 18, UC plus CT equals U to T. So 6 plus 18 equals UT, and 6 plus 18 is 24. So we'll plug 24 in for UT. That's going to be proportional to BU, which is our unknown, over CU, which is 6. Now we'll cross multiply. 12 times 6 equals 24 times BU. 12 times 6 is 72, and that's equal to 24 times BU. So when I divide by 24, I'll get that 3 is equal to BU. So this length is 3. Now I can plug BU and SU into my equation for SB. So SB is our unknown, or our indicated length that we're trying to find, and adding that to 3 will give us SU, which is 12. So all we need to do is subtract 3 from both sides to get that SB is equal to 12 minus 3, which is 9. So our indicated length is 9. In number 16, they give us multiple side lengths, but we're only going to look at this side length QR corresponds to this side length VW. We also know that this side length of PR corresponds with this side length of PW. So we have QR over PR, that's going to be proportional to VW over PW. QR is 12 over PR of 22, that's proportional to VW of 6 over PW, which is our unknown length. Cross multiplying, I'll have 12 times PW, and that's going to be equal to 6 times 22. So 12 times PW equals 6 times 22, which is 132. And when I divide by 12, I'll get that PW, that indicated length, is equal to 11. So 11 is our missing side length in number 16. Now for our next set of directions, 17 through 20, we're going to solve for x. And it says that the triangles in each pair are similar. So as opposed to solving for the length, we're just solving for x. BC over DC, 60 over 50, is going to be proportional to SR, which is 11x minus 4, over ST of 70. So I'm going to cross multiply and solve. 60 times 70 is going to be equal to 50 times 11x minus 4. So I can distribute the 50, or I can just divide it out. And I'll start by dividing. That way my 50 will cancel out. 60 times 70 is 4,200, and when I divide that by 50, I'll get 84. So 84 is going to be equal to 11x minus 4. I'll add 4 to both sides in order to isolate the term with the x. 84 plus 4 is 88, and that's going to be equal to 11x. When I divide by 11, 88 divided by 11 is 8, and 8 is equal to x. So x is 8 in number 17. In number 18, again, I'll set up my proportion. AB, 77, over CB, 11x plus 11, is going to equal EF, 21, over GE of 30. Remembering to keep the corresponding sides on the same side of the fraction bar. So since AB corresponds with EF, those are both in the numerator, and CB corresponds with DE, so those are in the denominator. Now we'll cross multiply. 77 times 30 is going to equal 21 times 11x plus 11. Now again, here I can distribute that 21 or I can divide. I'll go ahead and divide by 21 instead. So when I divide both sides by 21, 77 times 30 will give me 2,310. And dividing that by 21, I'll get 110. So 110 is going to be equal to 11x plus 11. My next step, I'll subtract 11 from both sides in order to isolate that term with the x. 110 minus 11 is 99. So 99 equals 11x. And when I divide by 11, I know that 11 goes into 99 9 times. So 9 is equivalent to x in number 18. In number 19, I'm given multiple different side lengths, so I have a couple different options. I can use KL and UT, or I can use JL and JT. Let's use KL and UT. So KL of 96 corresponds with UT of 36. So we're going to have 96 in the numerator and 36 in the numerator. And then KL over the side length of JK, which is 64, is going to be equal to that 36 over what corresponds with JK, which is JU, negative 4 plus 4x. Now I'll cross multiply and solve. So we'll have 96 times negative 4 plus 4x. That's going to be equal to 64 times 36. I'll start by dividing both sides by 96. And when I work out the math, negative 4 plus 4x is going to equal 64 times 36, which is 2,304, and dividing that by 96 will give me a positive 24. Now I'll add 4 to both sides. Adding 4 to both sides, I'll get that 4x is equal to 24 plus 4, which is 28. So when I divide by 4, x will equal 28 divided by 4, which is 7. So 7 is x in number 19. And if I wanted to solve for that side length JU, I would just plug 7 in for x and calculate. And lastly in this video, and on this worksheet, number 20. Before I go over the answer to this, please remember to subscribe to my channel. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. They also encourage me to come out with more videos for you. So the more subscriptions, hopefully, the more videos. Now, let's go over number 20. The side length of 88 VW corresponds with the side length of 24 ST. So 88 and ST of 24 will be in the numerators. And then I'll have VU, which is 5x plus 11, and SU of 18 in the denominators. Now I'll cross multiply. 88 times 18 equals 24 times 5x plus 11. And just to show you that you can indeed distribute, I'll go ahead and distribute that 24. So 88 times 18 is equal to 1,584. And that's going to equal 24 times 5, which is 120x, plus 24 times 11, which is 264. So now I'll subtract 264 from both sides. 1,584 minus 264 is 1,320. And that's going to be equal to 120x. So when I divide by 120, I'll get that 11 is equal to x. So 11 is x and number 20. And with that last answer, we wrap up this video. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and share. Also, feel free to leave a comment below.